Gary, many congratulations, and it made up for 1987.
Yes, it certainly did. It was a tremendous feeling going up those steps, picking up the cup today, especially after the way the game started, obviously going behind from a Stuart Pearce free kick, then losing Paul with hopefully not too serious injury. And it really was an uphill struggle. First half, we threw a lot at them, and unfortunately, the keeper made a couple of good saves. We missed the penalty. But at half time, he said, look, we're playing quite well, keep playing the same way, hopefully we'll get the same chances. And then we got a great chance second half when Paul Stewart went through, and then put it into extra time. And fortunately for us, unfortunately for Nottingham Forest, an own goal won it for us.
You know what Des Walker must be feeling?
Exactly. I mean, it was a terrible feeling for me after 1987. And the other thing for Des, I think I was coming in behind him, so I think I was just about to knock the ball into the net, and he got in front of me and headed it in for me. But I think he had to try and clear it, and unfortunately went straight in the net.
Gary, many congratulations. They tell me the first medal you've actually won.
In England, won the Cup, won the Cup Winners' Cup and the Spanish Cup, but the FA Cup's so special. It's such a special day that I think this is certainly my best moment in football. It's fabulous.
Let's get rid of the bad moment you had in the first half. I mean, did that set you back a lot?
Well, personally, it didn't do me the world of good, but those things happen. You score some and you miss some. I would have felt a lot worse now if we'd have ended up losing, but I've not only got the feeling of immense joy, but of immense relief as well. So, with those two emotions coupled, it makes it very special.
It was a great loss to us when we lost Paul Gascoigne. And as far as I'm concerned now, that goal and the cup belongs to him, because he's played an important part, as far as I'm concerned, in the FA Cup this year. And as far as I'm concerned, that was for you, Gazza.
Tell us about the goal.
I managed to find myself on the right getting forward. Paul Allen played a great ball. I knocked it on once and managed to bury it in the corner. And I've never experienced anything in my life as good as that goal.
Absolutely delighted.
These days, Cup Final heroes can share their triumphs by phone on surely the best journey any footballer can take. From Wembley in triumph. A job had been well done and everyone, not least a beaming manager, knew it. It was a time for quiet satisfaction for seasoned internationals like Gary Lineker, for more obvious jubilation from young players like David Howells. And as for the poor old cup, of course it got its usual treatment. Jubilation inside the bus was reciprocated outside, but of course one well-known voice and face just wasn't aboard, and first stop was to be hospital to see Paul Gascoigne. Paul Stewart took him his winner's medal, the captain took him the cup. In the pandemonium, the hospital confirmed their famous patient had serious ligament damage to his right knee, though tonight there is more optimism than there was earlier today.
He's a little sad. We've took the whole team back and went and saw him, showed him the cup, and he was happy, sad, happy and sad, and which is natural. And the lads really think a lot of him. They really do. He's got a lot of admiration from all the players, and they all wanted to go there. That's the first thing they thought about. And that's not always the case, and it was nice. It was good to see him.
How serious is the injury, as you understand it?
It's possible he's going to have an operation in the morning. I don't think it's as bad as it was first thought, but I'll leave that to the experts. I'm not qualified to say.
I have to ask you where this leaves his possible move, or where, and Lazio and the Italians,
no,
and all that sort of thing.
I would think it's in their lap now, because we was under the impression something may happen this week, and we've been fighting to try to stop that if we could. But this is obviously thrown the spanner in the works once again.
Tonight at London's Hilton Hotel, such concerns certainly aren't for a triumphant team. They'll relish the night and tomorrow's victory parade in North London as well. A short time ago, Terry Venables embraced Bill Nicholson, manager of the famous double team, a historic day for a famous club. But hard realities will still have to be faced.
I sincerely hope, and always have done, that Gascoigne will play for Spurs next season. I've always felt that. And I've made my public position clear that if Gascoigne leaves, I will leave the club myself anyway. There's no doubt about that. And I said that months and months and months ago. And I would carry that out.
So do you now feel the likelihood is he will stay or that he'll go?
This moment in time, I mean, Gaz got a terrible injury today. I think he's in hospital at the moment, and I think we'll have to look at the medical reports first. But I sincerely hope he does stay.
And Lineker?
Oh, Linico, I mean, some stories that reach the newspapers, I've got an idea how they get there, but I'm afraid to say that, you know, perhaps people have tried to undermine us on Cup Final week. You know, when stories come out like that 3 days before the Cup Final, they're not designed to help us.
Have today's events, all today's events, actually put resolving all the off-the-field problems further back then?
I don't know. I'm not really going to think about that tonight because we've had all this week. In fact, this week, in the evenings, everything, it's still been going on because we was trying to do something before the Cup Final. It wasn't possible. We're just going to relax tonight and business as usual Monday morning, I would say.
Sum up today and what it means to you for us.
Very difficult. Unexplainable, really. I think it's felt so good. Because it was a bit like a fairy story, the fact that we've had these problems. Just the mere fact I've got involved in some ways, or sometimes I've thought, excuse me, sometimes I've thought, is this worthwhile? And then you think, you look at people and supporters, you think, yes, we've got to keep going, got to keep going to the death, and it's been difficult. And what it has done, win, lose or draw, it's kept us together to get to a cup final, and then eventually on top of that, win it, which, seeing those supporters today when I was walking around was special, and I was really thrilled for them, you know.
Could there be a better day?
I haven't seen one yet. Let's hope there is a better day, but it was a special day for me, and I think for lots of people. Staff, as well as the players and the supporters, everybody's been unsure about what's going on. And there's nothing you can really say to appease them at the moment. And we've all hung on in there, and it's been a fairy tale ending.
But not for Gascoigne.